silence filled the barn. Chico heard a slight hum and moved through the box, looking for sound. It grew stronger when he came to the far corner. Then he heard whispers in the sound. "We are here, we are here." He made his way through the old things. That's when he came across a big ball of soft red wool next to two long needles. Toko pointed his mighty beak and started tapping on the center of the lid. In a few moments, he had cut the rope that held it tied together. He pushed his beak between the edges of the box and poked it with a strong upward movement. The top of the box opened, revealing its contents. "Bravo!" Chico shouted. "Now lift the objects and move them to the side." Chico returned to the corner where the large ball of wool was stored. Toko followed the instructions by easily grabbing the old heirlooms with the tip of his beak and placing them on the side of the box. Then he came across the red ball. "What is it?" he asked. "It's an old ball of red wool. I think it was symbolically important to this family. It could be magic," said Chico. "Really?" replied Toko. "It looked like something discarded. It looks familiar." "I found some very special things in my life among discarded items," said Chico. "Why do you say it could be magic?" "Because it's so full of love and memories that it's just not a thread anymore. It is imbued with the energy of the person who wore it. The supreme love of the mothers, the grandmothers who worked on it, and the babies or children who wore it," Chico said. "Touch it with your beak." Toko leaned forward and gently placed his giant beak on the ball of wool. His orange beak became a more vivid color, and his eyes opened wide. The feathers on his head rose up. "Wow, what power! I get goosebumps everywhere, and we toucans never get goosebumps," said Toko, laughing. "I wonder why it was put away in a box," said Chico. "Or maybe someone didn't want to remember that kind of love." "How can you not want the joy of that warmth?" Toko asked. "Because maybe there's no one to share it with, except the animals," said Chico. "Well, we must do something about that," said Toko. Toko remembered the story when Pio talked to Beatrice and saw the ball on the table with the needles. He came up with a plan to put the magic red thread in its place. Perhaps Beatrice would pick it up without realizing the exchange. "But what good will it do if she hasn't found love yet?" Toko wondered. "I have an idea," said Chico. "When I touched it with my tongue, I remembered the man I escaped from, Mr. Lancey. He's an explorer by trade, and that's how he found me. He travels the world and is so busy with his work that he imagines he has no time for someone to love." "How do you know so much?" Toko asked. "For the same reason you do, Toko. We recognize the magic of love. We see it. We live it." "That's true," said Toko. "I've met animals up here that are only interested in eating." "Even when it's right in front of their eyes," added Chico. Toko took the ball of wool in his mouth with great care. He felt his eyes fill with tears as a thousand images flowed into his mind and told his heart about kisses, hugs, tears, laughter, all experiences of love transmitted from mother to child.